I'm Kellyann Ripner, and I work at all of our 4 UK sites. That's because my role is a global project manager and I work within product certification. In this part of the business, we offer testing and certification services. The products we test range from horse riding helmets and personal safety to windows and doors, where we have robots that do some of the testing for us too.
Literally, I've been doing Lean Six Sigma projects within BSI since the day I joined the organisation. They've been in a variety of different areas and covered a massive number of different subjects. All of them have worked incredibly well. All of them have made a difference. And so I simply wanted to continue with this particular approach to this particular challenge.
I have been interested in Lean Six Sigma prior to BSI. Within my business degree, I researched into operational and financial efficiencies, and this mirrors Lean Six Sigma principles.
Our sales to revenue process for many years has been, it's been difficult for people to understand. Lots of challenges, lots of people have lots of opinions, but nobody has any facts. The idea of broaching this from a Lean Six Sigma perspective this time is first of all to understand what the challenges are, to get some real data behind it, challenge the assumptions that we have made for many, many years, fix the problems based on known data, and then be able to check that we've actually fixed them at the end and seen things done differently in the future.
It's a tried and tested method, so most importantly, we're looking for customer satisfaction and trying to improve that.
If we get this right, it'll do two things for our business. Three things for our business. Firstly, it'll give a greater level of understanding. More importantly, it will improve our customer experience when we're onboarding new customers. And then there are the financial benefits. We will improve our revenue, we'll improve our profit. So in all of those regards, it's a great thing to do. Fixing this project, it is central to our business and really understanding it. Growth is the agenda for product certification going forward.
Lean focuses on reducing waste, both money and time, as well as the need to rework. The benefits of this also increases the value for the customer. Six Sigma looks at the statistical side to reduce product as well as process variation. Overall, the focus is on continuous improvement and using a project approach. Well, to be honest, I found this stage particularly tricky. Within Define, it's important to be specific and not allow the scope of the project to keep on increasing and drown you. Occasionally, I would do some analysis for fun and find something interesting or realise another part of the process wasn't currently working as well as it could. However, it was important to record this finding and move it aside to come back to at a slightly later date. You could see this slightly similar to the Pareto and 80-20 process, where I would concentrate on the items that matter most. This was sometimes hard to do as my day-to-day job is as a global project manager, wherein normally, if something can be potentially fixed or improved, I would naturally start this right away. The overriding learning point for me is to have a structure. The Define phase pushes you to do this, literally pushes you to do this. As this is my first official Lean Six Sigma project, I found myself on occasions going around in circles, a little wary as to which project to choose, possibly going too far into analyse phase too early, but Define always brings you back. To be honest, it reminds me of when you get into a car, you check the seat, the mirrors, the steering, maybe the height of the seat, if you're a little bit short like myself. Is there enough petrol to get you there? The lights are working, you get the point. But basically, are you ready to go safely to the next point on your journey? So that leads us to measure.